Hello, everyone, and welcome to a gargantuan edition of AEW Dark. I am Excalibur, joined by the human suplex machine, Taz, and absolutely blessed to be joined by Absolute Ricky Starks.
It's an honor and a privilege to be back here at the commentating booth with you and Taz.
Ricky, you are my favorite announcer by far.
Okay, he's a member of Team Taz. Can you put over the brand?
Team Taz.
ShopFTW.com, but let's not wait any further. Let's throw it down to our colleague, Justin Roberts, standing by inside the ring.
This contest is set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching a ring weighing 275 pounds, Luchasaurus.
Well, Luchasaurus escorted to the ring by the other members of Jurassic Express, Marco Stunt and Jungle Boy.
And Luchasaurus, it's just like he gets bigger by the day, this dinosaur. He's 65 million years old.
Hey, you got it right.
What do you mean? Oh, I've said trillion.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
It's a big difference. Oh, boy. Oh,
wait a minute.
Oh, hold on. Hold on.
Boys, I'm going to address the elephant in the room. No, I'm sorry. The woolly mammoth. Mark, stop. Stop. Not that. No. I'm talking about the dragon. There are no dragons in AEW. Now, why should you believe a talking dinosaur? Because I have a master's degree. So, Cutler, we know it's you. Get out here and let's do this.
A man of few words.
Well, listen, it's impressive to have a master's degree, especially the colleges back in the day weren't as good.
Not
he went to school. many millions of years ago, the universities were different.
Were they Ivy League?
No, but there was no ACTs, there was no SATs, nothing.
And his opponent, from Rancho Cucamonga, California, weighing 192 pounds, Brandon Cutler.
Taz. How dare you call into question the credentials, the accreditation of the Medieval Studies program at Cal State Northridge?
Yes, right. I know. I digress. Wow, look at this. Mask versus mask, a dinosaur versus a dragon.
I like that the dragon mask has all teeth as well.
I like that the dragon has a Nike elbow pin.
Attention to detail, Taz. That's what it's all about here.
That's what he's taught me.
There we go. Taz has put me over. All right. This is interesting. Two large individuals.
Well, Cutler giving up just about an inch or so in height, but more than a few pounds to Luchasaurus.
Look at this.
Rolls him up, high stack.
Smart by Cutler. Hey, your opponent turns your back. You got to do what you got to do. That was very smart by Cutler.
Cutler escapes between the ropes and between the legs of Luchasaurus. Wow. Goes to the outside.
No hair to grab, Luchasaurus.
Great kick there by Cutler. Staggers Luchasaurus back into the ring.
Nice.
High Gamangiri with Luchasaurus.
Oh, was that growl?
Oh.
Yeah. Not so fast.
I love when Team Taz does the synchronized.
Ha ha! We practice that all the time.
No, we don't.
Okay.
We're just in sync.
Well, you guys didn't do it there.
Because he was being disrespectful to his elders.
That's why.
Oh!
I thought he was doing a good job putting Luchasaurus over.
That's true. He's the oldest man in the room. So. Oh, watch out there, high pose referee.
Jeez.
Is Marco Stunt vagrant?
Marco Stunt and Jungle Boy had a tough night. Last Wednesday at Dynamite, when they were just brutalized by FTR, Marco specifically.
Yeah, no kidding, that's a fact. And speaking of being brutalized, those chops are brutal.
You have to imagine that the rivalry between FTR and Jurassic Express is far from over.
Oh, I completely agree with that, for sure. And you see Cutler trying to get away from the very powerful Luchasaurus. Not gonna happen.
Love it. Simple and effective.
Sometimes you gotta ram someone's skull into a steel guardrail. It happens.
In case you were keeping track, it is raining here.
Yes.
In Northeast Florida. First time for everything.
Snow too, man.
Yeah, enough of the snow. Sick of snow in Florida.
Oh, the teep from Luchasaurus. sent Cutler into the barricade, and the big boot sent him over.
Took his damn head off.
He's gone.
He's on the outside of the barricade.
Get him back, Beal back in.
Ooh!
Bradley Beal Jones.
I have a question. Where's the count? Why isn't Posey doing his job?
He's on Sesame Street.
He is counting, but then the count was broken briefly.
Count, count, count.
Thank you. I'm deaf in one ear, so can't hear as well.
Maybe you're blind in one eye. I don't know.
That's cataracts. Thanks, Taz. Appreciate you.
Just saying. You've been through a lot of issues lately out here in AEW because of the cheating and the tomfoolery that's been going on.
Shenanigans.
Yeah.
Brandon Cutler.
Oof. Ooh.
Tope Suicida driving Luchasaurus into the barricade. Returns Luchasaurus to the ring underneath the bottom rope. Cutler elevates over the top rope. Slingshot sent on there. And the LDL long distance leg drop. Luchasaurus tried to get the hands up, but.
Didn't get all of it.
All the power right there by Luchasaurus. It's tough to keep that dinosaur down.
Big digging right hands there from Brandon Cutler. Luchasaurus. Caught, the knee strike, the boot, and the headbutt just dropped Cutler.
Muay Thai-like movements by the dinosaur. The dojos in Thailand at least 30 million years ago were great. Oof.
Well, it wasn't Thailand quite then. It was Pangea still, but
nice. Oh, that's so obnoxious of you, Excalibur. Really, please. We have a guest here in Ricky Starks. You're better.
How do you make a game plan against a dinosaur? I've been wondering.
Well, how do you make a game plan against a, Cutler supposed to be? Dragon.
Come on, you. Come on.
Exactly,
man.
Well said.
Come on.
Cutler escapes. Luchasaurus, I mean, had he hit that, he might have broken Cutler's neck.
Oh!
Brandon Cutler up, Luchasaurus down on the mat. Cutler elevating over the top rope.
My headset went out there, but that was pretty. That was crazy. Let me just say it. That was stupid and crazy.
Cutler really stringing things together. The springboard, the elbow drop across the jaw of Luchasaurus. Look, Cutler slow to capitalize.
That was an excellent springboard elbow. Oh, now look at Luchasaurus.
Cutler off the middle rope, double knee strike there.
I think he got the orbital bone. I think he broke the orbital bone with those knees.
And Cutler once again, another elbow drop.
Might get a big
one
here.
Two, no.
I'm thinking that probably would have been upset right there if Cutler would have got the win, even though he has been on a roll.
Yeah, he's been on a, I believe, 8-match winning streak, has Brandon Cutler. Luchasaurus competing primarily as a tag team competitor alongside Jungle Boy. They are currently ranked number 2 in the tag team division, but Cutler doesn't care about that now.
He's rolling the dice here.
Rolls. Oh, the hook kick.
Usually rolls a polyurgic dice, not dice. Right? Yeah, that's it. Might be done.
One, two.
Oh, wow. Polyhedral, right?
Polyhedral.
You were right. All right.
Well,
someone
said
was.
Dice, and then it's a die.
Oh. I don't play craps.
Dire.
Or gamble.
Dire plural.
I don't play craps.
Nice. Yeah, nice. We're adults.
Oh! I just cover him now. The match has got to be over.
Cutler absolutely blasted with that kick, courtesy of Luchasaurus.
The winner of this match, Luchasaurus.
I think if Luchasaurus had hit a choke slam that spiked Brandon Cutler directly on his neck and head, the match would have been over sooner. But still, Luchasaurus able to put Brandon Cutler away and pick up the victory here tonight on AEW Dark. Sammy Guevara of the Inner Circle will be in singles action coming up next here on AEW Dark.
This contest is set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Mexico City, Mexico, weighing 165 pounds, El Australiano.
El Australiano making his first ever singles appearance here on AEW Dark. And Taz, you heard that right. His name is El Australiano, but he's from Mexico City, Mexico.
Yes, it could be a tad confusing for some, but we've seen this athlete compete last week here. He's something special. He's tremendous.
He's a high flyer. He likes to shake his tassels, his ruffles, but a high flyer that likes to shake his tassels and ruffles as well.
Going to have his hands full here with Guevara, that's for sure.
And his opponent from Houston, Texas, weighing 184 pounds. They call him a Spanish god, Sammy Guevara.
Interesting that Sammy's not called El Tejano in this match.
Well, I'll tell you what, X-Pal, you're bringing jokes. You brought jokes earlier. You made a mention about a machine and stuff because what we saw happen, okay, where Darby Allin was victorious, unfortunately, over, you know, Brian Cage. And Sting attacked the man to your right, Ricky Starks, with a weapon.
Yeah.
And I am sick of this. I need to have a meeting with Tony Khan and one of these EVPs that are in this company. I'm tired of
them. Taz. Sting only attacked Ricky Starks after Ricky Starks laid hands on Darby Allin.
I'm here to talk about my friend Sammy Guevara.
He's awesome. I love Sammy.
I love Sammy, too.
Sammy Guevara will be competing in a big three-way tag team matchup tomorrow night on Dynamite. The Inner Circle will decide who is their tag team, who will go after the AEW World Tag Team Championship. It'll be Guevara and Hager taking on Jericho and MJF and Santana and Ortiz tomorrow night, 8-7 Central on AEW Dynamite.
Look at the poise of Sammy Guevara. I mean, he's so chill. He's so focused.
Yeah.
You know, Ricky, you and Sammy have a lot of similarities.
Yeah, we came up together, actually.
I know that. And you bring a little more intensity to the beginning of the match, where Sammy's more laid back. That's kind of his thing. But as you know, he amps up his intensity. And that's a nice mat return. A little spin drill action here by Sammy.
Nice. Sorry, guys. Excuse my low voice. I have a bruised trachea. So.
Well, you got attacked by a legend, an icon, Sting, with a baseball bat in your throat.
Put a little musical inflection on that, Taz.
That was perfect.
I hate when he says that. So don't do that.
I hate he, meaning Tony Schiavone.
Sorry, bro. Hey!
There we see the moves from El Australiano.
He's doing the Mamba.
A little stiff in the hips, but oh.
Slap worked.
Swing and a miss there. Australiano, hell stab. Tough shot to the throat.
Hello, Australiano. Sammy Guevara.
Guevara, excuse me. Pump kick caught. Guevara went for the Enziguri. Australiano.
Oh, come on, Sammy.
Twisting senton there.
Oh.
Went for the sweep. The Tierras.
Oh.
And Guevara getting sent for a ride here. And once again, really moving those hips.
Shakira needs to call in.
Crazy hips. Should play that Shakira song throughout the whole match when this guy wrestles.
Shakira,
la 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 la.
We're so there,
Sammy,
man.
Come on now. You gotta turn around this thing here.
Australiano off the middle, off the top. Goes over.
Surprise Sammy. Oh, an area code shot.
Come
I'm surprised that Sammy, Ricky's getting a little banged up here.
Australiano coming off the top.
Oh, man.
And Ricky, a look of concern on your face for Sammy Guevara.
Yeah, because I know how that feels. Probably how it felt when Sting hit me right in my stomach, you know?
Yeah, I mean, that's a human being.
This tracheal injury seems to come and go, Ricky.
No, it's
there.
Well,
that's part of the issue.
Don't question my injuries. Yes. Come on. I thought we were going good.
Let's see what Australiano is up to here. He's dangerous area right now. He's
getting his footing on the
jeez.
Top, and he came crashing down on Guevara.
I think he kind of slipped a bit because the bandana is covering his eyes.
I'll tell you, this guy is just some kind of just crazy acrobatic style, flying around and usually mixing that lucha style. What's up?
Usually the reckless high flying is the type of attacks that Sammy Guevara likes to favor.
Yeah. But a little bit more precision in it.
Thing is, now Australiano, he can't follow up, and that's giving Sammy some time to recover. Sammy, you know, he's kind of underrated in regards to his resiliency and toughness, you know, because he's so poised and chill and Spanish God, for God's sakes.
Well, that's why he was so highly recruited by Chris Jericho to join Inner Circle.
Oh!
Dragon Rana here by Australiano. One, two, no!
Upset that would have been. Tell you what, Sammy's got to try to turn this thing around here quick.
Yeah, Sammy is in a lot of trouble ahead of that big three-way tag team match tomorrow night on Dynamite.
just give it some time. Sammy's going to find the groove. You
Look,
know,
Ricky,
he doesn't rush
you know
it.
Sammy well. I'm sure you're pretty surprised at this, though, what's going on.
I am. But, you know, I never count him out.
No, me too. I don't count him out at all.
Australiano goes for the kick. Guevara able to avoid. See?
Oh, man.
My man picks his spots. That's what I'm talking about.
Just kicked homie in the back of the head. That was sweet.
Boom.
Give you a lot of credit. Ricky, coming out here as a guest commentator, and your voice box was damn near destroyed by Sting.
Yes.
Sting!
I hate that.
Australiano thrown into the barricade, and Sammy Guevara, this is... Taz, we've seen this a few times over the last few weeks here on Dark. Sammy Guevara, he gets that look in his eye. He starts chomping down on that gum, and the mean streak comes out.
Yeah, he definitely – great point, Excalibur. That's what it is. It is a mean streak. He could snap very quick, and we've seen Guevara do that a lot. That was nice. That's it.
Flipped him over into the DDT. No, Australiano not out of this one yet.
Shades of Katoro Suzuki, huh?
Kotaro Suzuki move.
Good toughness right there from Australiano. I said his name wrong.
No, Taz, you got it.
You gotta get a more marketable name, bro. I mean, seriously.
I'll just call him Australia.
That's a good idea, actually. The Australia. El Australia.
Or The Australian.
The Australian. Okay. But he's from Mexico City.
Well, he resides in Mexico City. He's originally from Australia.
Sammy.
Guevara shooting star. Press nobody home.
The chain weighed him down. That's what happened.
Perhaps threw off his center of gravity. Yeah. Australiano headed up to the top.
And this guy is comfortable that here he goes, that maybe with that sideways moonsault we saw. He caught some of it.
But not all of it.
But he came up clutching his midsection after he came down.
See what he did, though, Sammy? He goes from the side off the buckle. He said, you don't see that much. I mean, I know you can do that. I know that.
What a veteran move.
Are you just ignoring me, sir? Ricky? I mean, I'm just
putting
you over.
I got hit in the ear as well, so.
Oh, I know. You're right.
I'm working with that. I'm sorry. It happened again.
We got to talk to Doc Sampson. You're in no shape to be out here on commentary.
Oh, even the doctor doesn't like us. Trust me.
Big elbow strikes there from Sammy Guevara, sends Australiano into the ropes, but he gets the elbow up to Sammy Guevara as he's charging in.
Whoa.
Australiano, oh, wow. Sammy Guevara with that catch of the GTH.
Done.
That's
done.
My man.
One,
I love it.
Two,
three.
Good job, Sammy. That was good.
Winner of this match, Sammy Guevara.
Tell you what, El Australiano put up a hell of a fight, had a hell of a show, and even Sammy's impressed. But there it is, Bell knee to the face. Thanks for coming.
The GTH ended the night for Australiano. Sammy Guevara looking good ahead of that big three-way tag team matchup tomorrow night on Dynamite. Guevara and Hager take on MJF and Jericho and Santana and Ortiz.
All right.
The secret, Taz, has spoken into existence.
I'm going to make this quick. I know Taz has after parties to get to.
Yeah, buddy.
So I'm going to make this real quick. You, Jamie, zoom in on my shoulder. Right there. If I look at it just like that, can you see it? Can you see it?
Oh, no.
No, that's right. You probably can't see it. But I feel it. I feel it every single day. And the weight gets heavier and heavier and heavier every single day, week, month, year that goes by. It's this chip on my shoulder, baby. It's this chip on my shoulder, but it's okay. Because this is a workout. Because let's be honest, there's going to be gold around these shoulders. And let's be honest, not only am I carrying AEW Dark, but I'm carrying Dynamite, every single pay-per-view I've ever been on, because I'm so damn good, because I'm the best worker this company has. What? Oh, I'm just Chris Jericho's friend. Oh, like that's the reason I'm here. Now, it's no secret. Jericho brought me into AEW. He did. But here's a little secret for you.
I wasn't some friend favor of Jericho's. No. Jericho is not only my father figure, my mentor, but you might as well call him a scout, because he saw me busting my ass on the independents before I even knew him. And he said, we need Sammy Guevara in AEW. Clap for the GOAT. So let me set that record straight right now. I'm here because of work, and nothing more than work. And that's what's gonna get me every single AEW championship they have. One belt's not enough, I'm gonna have them all. So whoever, Jeff, anybody in production, I don't care, update the rankings. Because rather it's Darby or it's Kenny, I'm coming for everybody.
Sammy Guevara.
This is my moment to shine. This is my time for flight. I've been grinding forever.
Sammy putting everybody on notice, let people know what's up. I might have missed one of my after parties, by the way. I went a little longer than I thought. It's always good to hear Guevara. Passionate, man. Big chip on the shoulder.
Be careful of my phlegm. The future is mine. Take it. We didn't even really get to touch on you and Sean Spears. How's your back?
It's a little bit sore.
Oh my God.
What's up? I want to talk about Wrestling with the Week. Whatever we have interest in, we're going to chop it up. Did you get the PS5? I'm over here all weekend playing PS4 like a heathen.
Scorpio Sky and myself, James Willems, we got distracted. We're going to be talking about video games. We're going to be talking about pop culture. Have you seen the New York Subway Rat Man?
What?
We're going to be recapping AEW. It's the most exciting part of the show. We're basically going to be talking about the week.
We got a lot to get into, man.
It's also what the people want to see.
Oh, my God.
Voila.
This is progress. Scorpio Sky, James Willems, Wrestling with the Week.
Wrestling with the Week. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Make sure you subscribe now.
Woo.
It's beautiful. I love it.
Big and bad, Nick Camarado will go one-on-one with Scorpio Sky of SCU next here on AEW Dark.
This bout is set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring first from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 278 pounds, Nick Camarado.
Nick Camarado is one of the burliest, one of the most intense, the most physical competitors we've seen on Dark in some time. And Taz, I understand you got a little bit of information about Camarado.
I do.
His background.
Oh, yes. We were talking earlier. Easy. Yeah. Hey, listen, Ricky, you know what? Okay. Yeah, no, Nick
Put a pin in that, Taz.
Okay, sure, no problem. I'll be a junior man jobber here, and I'll just lay out.
And his opponent, from Los Angeles, California, weighing 208 pounds, Scorpio Sky.
I'm always reaching for the sky. I'm like Scorpio Sky. Reach for the sky.
Scorpio Sky, of course, host, co-host of the brand new podcast, Wrestling with the Week. Bill One.
Sky.
Spotify, YouTube, wherever you find your podcast. New episodes every Monday.
Reach for the sky. No, you know what? You're not going to be on this podcast, Ricky. You know why? You're too busy training all the time. Always in the gym, hanging and banging, like Scorpio Sky.
You don't have a free hour a week, Ricky?
I can make it, but I want to be offered a podcast spot, just me and Team Taz.
Oh, yeah, Team Stars.
No, I was going to say Team Staz.
Team Staz, yeah.
Taz.
What?
A little bit more about Nick Camarado's background.
Nick Camarado, actually a hell of an amateur wrestler in his day. High school, college, a hell of a JUCO wrestler. That's a junior college for those that don't know.
Oh, I thought those were the big jeans you were wearing in the 90s.
JUCO.
For some people that don't understand how things work. But, massive size difference here of Camarado. But he doesn't use a lot of his amateur, abilities from, folk style wrestling. But, he's a big size advantage on guys a lot, so he just uses that power, I guess.
Tight grip there by Scorpio Sky.
Oh, stop the side headlock takedown.
Camarado sends Sky into the ropes, shoulder tackle.
I was actually witnessed a little bit of, I don't know if you did, Ricky, a conversation that Camarado had recently at a show here with Hook about a cauliflower ear, which is very interesting. I'll just leave it at that.
Explosive,
weren't there.
Explosive drop kick from Scorpio Sky back in Camarado into the corner. The uppercut. Oh, wow. Power there by Camarado. Oh,
what a shot. Sky brings the hits.
Oh.
Swing and a miss. Drop.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. Drop, no hold.
Oh.
Sky with the boot up.
Oh.
Takes Camarado down. Scorp covers, hook the far leg, barely a one count there. Short elbow drop.
Gotta try to keep, go ahead.
Just gonna ask a question about cauliflower ear because obviously I don't know anything about it. No, I wasn't there when Hook was talking to Nick about the cauliflower ear, but do you think Nick has both ears that are cauliflower ear?
No.
You can't really tell under that head of hair.
But and Hook doesn't have both cauliflower. One is, but there was a comment. I thought you were in a conversation. I should have even brought it up.
No, I was training.
I know you were training. You were training. Good point.
Oh
my God. Man, that was nasty on the spine. Jeez.
That's how you develop scoliosis.
Dude, oh, you develop. Yeah, you gotta be careful.
I'm straining.
How is your esophagus?
Oh, well, it's okay. It has
you
gold.
Should ice your throat.
Camarado, big stomp, driving his boot into the spine, the lower back. Scorpio Sky, man, what a scary look.
Yeah, you know, I got to tell you, he really is. Nick Camarado is just we sing his praises a lot for good reason. It's just a thick, like you said, burly athlete, that's kind of.
Man, really working over that L vertebrae there, huh?
Driving his shoulder. Oh, man. And you can see Sky immediately began grimacing.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, if you're joining us, you see Ricky Starks. He's speaking a little bit softer and lower than normal.
Oh,
man, Scorpio Sky hit the corner so hard, he knocked the corner cam out of focus.
Just bow and arrow in the spine, the lower back of Sky across the steel post.
I feel for Scorpio. We need a GoFundMe because that spine is ravaged, just like my trachea. That
and
sting.
Your esophagus. My sting attack you with a weapon.
It's focal cords.
Good luck getting help. Just, you know, he's one of the golden boys.
Scorpio Sky, that left jab, the right hook, the back elbow, though. He's got Camarado stunned a little bit. Crossbody attempt. Camarado catches him. And, man, the backbreaker. Camarado covers. Two. No.
Didn't Bane do that to Batman, and it took him 3 years to come back from that?
Was probably training through legs. I don't pay attention to children's shows.
It was a movie, but go ahead.
It was actually a comic book first.
Well, don't matter.
Who reads?
Bro.
Oh my God.
Yeah, nobody reads anymore.
Get out of here.
Go! It's actually a move very similar to Stu Grayson's Nightfall backbreaker.
Yes. Camarado just bending, trying to bend Sky in half. Tough for Sky to recover. You have someone attack your lower back.
Yeah.
It really can destroy you. Your body, it's tough to just move back. You know, your kidneys get affected by this also.
Yeah, especially, wind.
Especially because Sky, no, Camarado had it scouted. This could be an upset in the making here.
Single leg crab, just sit back a little more and you might get an upset victory.
Camarado winless thus far in his AEW career. That would be huge if he was able to defeat a former champion here in AEW. Scorpio Sky on the verge of tapping out.
Just tap out, man.
No, hey, he wants to hang on. He's got heart, he's got fight.
Oh, screw all that, tap out.
You know, you wouldn't tap out. I know how you are.
Well, I'm me. He's not me.
I understand that. Sorry. Don't get upset.
The throat has its limits.
Oh, low bridge there by Scorpio Sky as he pulled down the middle rope. Oh! He took Camarado over the top, but you saw Scorpio Sky's lower back did hit the ring frame, but comes over the top, crashing down.
I don't know if he caught his shin or his knee, Sky. He grabbed at his left
leg. And yeah, he's laboring as he gets up.
I'm telling y'all, after this match, his back is gonna look like a lowercase S.
Who's he? Oh, you're talking about Sky?
Scorpio Sky, S. Okay. His back.
S.
His
S.
Scorpio Sky headed up top.
Whoa.
Missile drop kick.
Oh, baby, what a missile drop kick for sure.
He's fired up now.
Back spin kick.
Oh, the stumps between the shoulder blades of Camarado. Scorpio Sky fighting through the pain here. He likes to use that TKO. Can he get Camarado up? No.
Not with the back injury, all that offense put on his back. Tough to do.
But smart man. Camarado.
Oh, man.
That's it.
The neck breaker.
Upset, upset.
Two. Whoa. Scorpio Sky fired those legs up.
He's a Camarado. He always punches himself in the head. Same side of his brain.
Taz, we've noticed that it's when he starts getting frustrated, instead of keeping his focus on the opponent, he starts smacking himself in the head.
Yeah, he's slightly deranged.
He has cradle cap.
That's funny. No, he does. I've seen him in catering, like, you know. Sorry, sir, no gratin of potatoes. And pop, 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 into his own head.
Oh-ho! High boot by Scorpio Sky. Camarado ate it for lunch, but he gets a second serving.
Oh, he got it.
Sky gets him up, fighting through the pain. TKO. Can he cover? Can he capitalize? One, two, three. Reach
for the sky. Winner of this match, Scorpio Sky.
Impressive by Scorpio Sky. Very impressive. I mean, he's a true pro. Able to power up Camarado for that TKO, even though his back was all screwed up. Hey, listen, man. I tell you what, guys, you got to tip your cap to Camarado. We had a hell of an outing here in this match.
I agree.
Yeah, he very nearly wrestled the perfect match against Scorpio Sky. But Sky's experience advantage, his heart, his perseverance, just a little too much for Nick Camarado. Scorpio Sky, your winner here tonight on AEW Dark. Portugal's perfect athlete, Shanna, will be in action next, coming up here on AEW Dark.
Next contest is set for a one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring from Salt Lake City, Utah, Marty Daniels.
Marty Daniels making her return to AEW Dark. Very powerful, skilled athlete.
She looks like a badass.
Tell you what, right now I've been to Salt Lake a lot in my life. A lot of crazy stuff happens there, bro. Been some wild things in Salt Lake.
Oh,
wild.
Tell me more.
Mountains make people crazy up in there.
God damn.
And her opponent.
It's like a team test meeting. That's what happens in the clubhouse.
Shanna.
Is that a footprint on Justin Roberts' back? Because you guys stepped all over his ring introduction.
He won't talk to me for 2 weeks.
I'm sorry. I didn't know. I'm new here.
Sorry, JR. That's the real JR, Justin Roberts. Shit. Oh, watch out.
That's dark after dark commentary here.
Ultra Doc. The real JR, Justin Roberts, ladies and gentlemen.
You're going to be in so much trouble, bro.
This is going to be a good matchup, I think. Why? Because look at the two different styles.
Shanna very motivated since making her return.
No one asked you why, though. You answered your own question, but I'm impressed by that. Sorry, X-File, you were speaking.
I was, thank you for acknowledging the fact that I speak sometimes.
I'm gonna lay out. Hold on. Watch out. Here comes Shanna on the hop. Back elbow right there.
Shanna brings Marty Daniels over, has the arm captured. Kind of an inverted crucifix there.
She didn't put her weight on it, though. You gotta put your body weight on these pins, folks, if you're watching at home. Pin the fight. Pin the person in the bar.
Pin the fight.
Shanna, a little bit of a hop, and then drops down the elbow across the chest. Daniels, leg drop. Shanna, opportunity here.
Well, Shanna went to pin the fight.
Yeah, insipid Ricky commentary. Thank you. I get it. Come on.
Bro, you need to trademark.
You mean inspired Ricky commentary.
Love it. All right, we're getting there.
Double overhooks by Shanna.
Break it.
Marty Daniels, great two-sport athlete in high school.
What sports?
Volleyball and basketball.
I knew it.
Tall?
Yeah.
Whoa! Stop City to the face.
Doc Martens right to the mouth.
Those are the shoes, Excalibur, Doc Martens. Big in the 90s.
Yeah, in London, UK. You know.
That was a hell of a volleyball. I played a lot of beach volleyball. Hold on, watch this.
Boom!
That's how dumb you think I am.
Oh. I don't think you're dumb at all. I think you're actually highly intelligent.
I think you're one of the smartest people here. You need
more? But I know at Coney Island back in the day, Coney Island, oh, in the whole company?
One of the three smartest people at the desk.
Yeah. Oh, well, I wouldn't go that far. I'm second.
I said one up. One up.
Okay, I'm second.
Oh,
wow.
Good Beal.
And that was not a Beal. That was not a Beal. She grabbed the girl by her hair. It was not a Beal. I'll teach you later what a Beal is. Okay? Been wrestling how many years now?
30.
Yeah.
Yeah. I bet you don't know who invented the Beal throw, but that's
Bradley.
No, it wasn't Bradley.
You accuse so many people of gimmick infringement. I got like one line, and you just
not decided. I just don't know.
First, JR makes a T-shirt out of my other line, and then now you steal my Brad.
Oh, okay. No, Shanna's on.
Oh, you're right about that. And Zegarry here knocking Marty Daniels back to the corner. Shanna charging in, big elbow strike.
Shanna's got to keep on. She's bringing the intensity. She's got to keep it on, though.
Shanna covering a lot of ground here.
Oh,
another shot. Takes Daniels off her feet.
He measured her up.
Oop, Shannon ducked under. Stunner.
She's feeling the energy. That's what they do in Dragon Ball Z. They feel the energy. They say, give me your energy.
That's a toy game.
It's a comic book intro. Oh, my God.
Drop kick to the face. She likes to use this tiger suplex.
Tiger suplex. Well,
look at the bridge.
She don't have a pin, though. She's got to turn her opponent to her back.
This is the best bridge.
That shoulder's up. Shanna, she's got the tiger suplex.
Whoa!
Plants her up high. Three.
The winner of this match, Shanna.
Good bridge.
Shanna continues her winning ways here on AEW Dark.
Well, we've seen her get victories with that tiger throw, that tiger suplex, double overhook. Tough, tough to kick out of that tight bridge, good bridge, tight lock.
Oof. Man, that drop kick across the bottom rope followed up by that tiger suplex. Shanna has been motivated. She has been on a roll since returning here to AEW late last year. What will the new year have in store for Portugal's perfect athlete? The Butcher and the Blade with the Bunny at their side will be in action next here on AEW Dark.
This is a tag team contest set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring at a combined weight of 435 pounds, the team of Baron Black and Mike Verna.
Taz, we are lucky enough to be joined by Anthony Ogogo here at the desk. And Anthony, always seems like you get paired up with Baron Black matches when we're on doing Dark.
I do. He's a great talent. He's a great talent. I'm not too sure what Mike Verna's wearing. Got a little boob tube on.
Yeah,
what's going on with that?
Well, it's a capy booby tube.
You heard it here first, folks.
And their opponents, being accompanied by the Bunny from Buffalo, New York, at a combined weight of 501 pounds, the Butcher and the Blade.
How sad for Mike Verna. that the last thing he may ever hear is KP Boobtube, because once Butcher and Blade get done with him, he may quit the business.
Oh yeah, no, Butcher and Blade, they beat the living hell out of people. That's how they roll. And you know, the Bunny, she motivates them. She's as vicious as they are.
She motivates them, but she also helps them. She gets involved on the outside. She is
she's a nasty piece of work.
A master of subterfuge.
She's a nice lady. I feel she's a nice lady, man. I really do. But she's definitely can be sketchy at times. I understand what you're saying.
Blade and Mike Verna starting things off here.
Ain't nothing sketchy about Blade's physique. Look at that man.
Great shape. Always in great shape, you know? Always.
Free Paul Turner trying to call for the clean break. Blade switching him into the corner.
You don't want to, you know, with Blade's experience, along with, to Anthony's point, is, you know, his physique, which brings a lot of power. His cardio is always on point. See how quick he snatched that wrist and turned it right into a hammerlock. Very smart. Now he's poking him out.
Yeah, paintbrushing him. And Verna, though, strong back elbow. Stops Blade. Shoulder tackle takes him off his feet. Verna hits the ropes. Blade goes for the trip.
Verna, she's a watch out. He's checked out his head. I think he's got that Grecian formula in his hair or something. Right, the Grecian.
It's actually the Italian formula. Oh, overhand chop. Anthony, I don't think Butcher and Blade are guys that you want to exchange strikes with.
No, you don't want to meet these two boys down the dark alley, do you?
Well, they kind of hang out in dark alleys, but yeah, you don't. I would not want to fight Butcher or Blade, or Bunny, for that matter.
Verna sent into the ropes. Wild swing and a miss there by Blade. A second miss. Verna. Oh, man. Tried the step up Rana, but Blade just dropped him.
I think Verna got a little too cute there and got caught. Baron Black, smart, not rushing in the ring, kind of taking his time, utilizing some poison. Oh, I didn't expect that. Look at that. Quick tag out.
Tag out to Big Butch.
There's those drop step like duck walks.
Butcher in that. Brand new trunks, reminiscent of the late great Shinya Hashimoto.
Hashimoto, you can throw some kicks, man, back in the day, Hashimoto.
Oh, Baron Black vaulting over the back of Butcher. Butcher.
Went for the old counter roll, didn't happen.
Oh, but Baron using his speed.
Nice job, Baron.
Ooh, spinning chop.
Whoop, watch out now.
But Butcher, power on display.
Ooh, that was nasty. Oof.
That was a great shot, Baron Black delivered, but he admired his work.
Yeah.
You can't admire work. This is a fight. This is a fight. Do your work and get on with it.
Yeah, he had his opponent stunned and was really, he took too much time. And now we see how dangerous the Bunny is.
What a nice girl.
Helping out her team, is that why?
Yes.
Just like Hook with Team Taz.
Bad story, but I understand. I understand.
Yeah, she's got better hair.
That's debatable. But I hear you. He's got pretty cool hair, I gotta tell you. I wouldn't want his hair, but that's how he is.
You know Bunny's gonna listen to this, and you know you are gonna get a nasty voicemail.
I'm gonna avoid her, yes.
We're having fun, but Butcher and the Blade are not. They are punishing Baron Black here.
And that's what myself and you and Anthony, we've been discussing, how intense they are, how violent and tough Butcher and Blade are. They bring it.
Anthony, how do you overcome such a significant power advantage that Butcher has over Baron Black?
Well, Baron Black has got to use his speed. He's a bit younger, he's a bit quicker than Butcher, so he's got to utilize his speed to stand any chance against that big man.
Butcher and Blade, though, tag team specialists. They've been ranked in the top five on multiple occasions last year. Went for the kitchen sink. Baron Black using his speed there. Very nearly got the upset. Steps over, single leg crab.
He has got a good figure four grip on that.
Oh, look at this.
That was quick. Quick, though.
Dug the nails into the eyes of Baron Black. And Blade sends Baron over to the corner, head first into that top turnbuckle pad. Quick tag out to the Butcher. Ooh.
Everybody's been poked in the eye. Everyone knows how much it hurts and how much you can, how much it disorientates you when you've been poked in the eye.
And if you have someone like, you know, Bunny with those nails, you basically can turn a Phillips head screw with a nail. Yeah, sorry, Excel.
Oh, no, I was going to say, I mean, Anthony, you know all too well about eye injuries in a fight.
Yeah, I've had 9 eye operations. I've broken my orbital bone 8 different places. But what's worse than that? Like, she could have easily scratched his cornea. Mm. When you scratch your cornea, you get double vision. You can't do anything.
And now just hammering Baron Black Baron, trying to cover up. Bunny just gleefully laughing. Nice and easy. Taz nice laughing as well, I guess.
She's
I guess
got a cool laugh. I mean, I don't know. It's kind of cool. A little annoying, but it's kind of cool.
Boy, that's another voicemail coming your way. Gotta change your number, bro.
Black's been in the ring for quite a while. He needs a tag.
He certainly does.
I don't think Vern is in a rush to get in this thing, though.
Baron Black, though, he was kicking those feet. He got back down to a vertical position. Rolls under the double clothesline. Now Mike Verna tags in. Drops blade. Elbow strikes to Butcher. Wow, Mike Verna.
Fighting his way out of this here. Came in hot.
Verna threw the kick, hit the enziguri. He suckered Butcher in. Great power slam. Oh, hey, oh.
Easy there, Paisan. Hold on a minute.
Swing blocked there by Butcher. Verna headed up top. Mike Verna drop kick knocked Butcher all the way to the corner. This is impressive, Anthony. He's taking on essentially a handicap match at this point.
Oh, what a shot. She got mine here.
Oh, once again, the eyes. This time it was Blade grabbing at the eyes of Mike Verna. A
lot of moving parts here, but I think Mike Verna's.
Oh, my God.
His midsection might be part of moving parts. Holy cow.
What a cross body. What a combination there for Butcher and Blade. Blade barking orders. Butcher line and wait. The power bomb neckbreaker combination ends the night.
Here are your winners, the Butcher and the Blade.
Anthony, you mentioned that you don't want to meet Butcher and Blade in a dark alley.
Yeah, listen, they are 2 degrees, Faze. They are two bad, bad men. But more than that, they're great wrestlers. That was a great performance from Butcher and the Blade.
I was going to say, you don't want to meet them in a dark alley. You don't want to meet them in a well-lit wrestling ring either.
No.
Man, they have brought the intensity. Taz, what more can we say about this?
Listen, Butcher bringing the speed on that. That just full speed cross body. And then right here, Mike Verna gets his lights put out by Butcher and the Blade.
A great victory for Butcher and the Blade. And you know, somewhere, Eddie Kingston, big smile on his face.
Who deserves the most prestigious wrestling honor? It's the first ever AEW Dynamite Awards, hosted by Tony Schiavone. Vote now at AEWAwards.com. This is the story of Matt and Nick Jackson, seen through their eyes. Over the past 20 years, they have documented their tireless journey, their triumphs, and their tribulations. And now they are ready to share their adventures with the world in their new book.
One day, let's grow up and let's be professional wrestlers.
This is the story of two brothers that became two loving fathers that went on to become the best tag team in professional wrestling today. This is the story of the Young Bucks killing the business.
Young Bucks, we're killing the business.
This contest set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit is a 6-man tag team match. Introducing at a total combined weight of 559 pounds, the team of Ryzen, Adam Priest, and Buddy Morales.
Interesting trio here tonight on AEW Dark. We've seen more of Ryzen than either of his two partners, but all three men formidable, impressive in their own right. How will they do as a trio here tonight?
And their opponents from Orlando, Florida, at a total combined weight of 690 pounds, Billy, Austin, and Colton, the Gun Club.
Taz, this trio of Gun Club has really strung together an impressive win-loss record over last year.
As much as I despise the Gun Club, I have to give them a lot of credit. Yes, Billy has his sons locked and loaded as a cohesive unit. They've been kicking ass and taking names as usual. He curries favor with the referee. That's Billy's been doing that for years. He used to pay refs off back in the day. He never beat me, but that's how he won a lot of matches. Just between you and me, bro, he used to pay people off. I'm telling you.
Well, he might have slipped something into Aubrey Edwards' pocket. I didn't get a clear look at it, but right now Billy and Varian Morales going to start things off for the match. And Colton Gunn got a free T-shirt, a commemorative T-shirt for Gun Club. Usually you have to go to Shop AEW for that.
That's true. Rumor has it Colton collects all of his dad's T-shirts. He saves them all in a trunk.
collar and elbow tie up there. Vary Morales sent to the canvas there by Billy. And he tags out, making a hasty retreat. Adam Priest enters the match. He goes for a collar and elbow tie up of his own.
Yeah, look at the size difference here.
Adam Priest, no match for Billy. Tags out to Ryzen.
Look at Ryzen. Yeah, Ryzen. You look better than Billy almost.
Oh, Ryzen. Suckered Billy in. Now hitting him with some right hands, peppering him. Sending him across. Nope, Billy reverses. Ryzen.
Oh, man. Side slam work right there for Billy.
And that side slam, when somebody the size of Billy delivers it, it's just got a little more oomph on it, Anthony.
Yeah, what's he, 6'5", 250, 260? He's a giant, giant man.
I've actually received a side slam from Billy Gunn back in the day, and to your point, Xalva, does hurt like the Dickens. And that was a nice drop kick right there by Colton. We've seen Colton, here we go, cover.
Covers here.
We've seen Colton Gunn, you know, we've seen him do drop kicks before. He's definitely, excellent at it. He's got all that height, good vertical leaping ability. Now Austin Gunn in there.
Billy with that that Dickensian side slam.
Yeah, Austin Gunn's the shy gun.
Wow, nothing.
I'm just trying to pull the action, Calvin. I'm trying to, you know.
You're a pro's pro.
That's it, brother.
Vary Morales goes underneath Austin Gunn, sends him into
the I was told I say things wrong at the end of sentences. I don't know. I mean, I get insulted here, so pardon me. Anthony heard it.
Anthony wasn't listening. Anthony wants no part of this right now.
I don't blame him.
I'm watching the fantastic action. What's going on right in front of my eyes?
This guy's a pro. Oh, he's going for the quick draw right there. He's trying to put away Vary Morales. Man, that kick. Well, the
Priest tagged himself in.
That kick was so solid, it dropped Austin. Oh!
Nice job by Priest.
Adam Priest just ran him over.
Yeah, Austin didn't realize Priest was legal, but you know, he came in hot there, did Priest.
I know Adam Priest quite well from the Nightmare Factory, the famed Nightmare Factory, and he's an intense little man. Very good wrestler.
Ooh, that's not really a positive thing as a guy who's under 6 foot, I can tell you. That L word is not a fun word, Anthony, I promise you.
Well, he lacks in height, he makes up for intensity and wrestling ability. Tremendous, tremendous little wrestler.
See, because you're a big man, Anthony. Big shot, that's one.
Vary Morales sends Austin Gunn into the corner. Is that a running inverted senton? Hits the clothesline. Covered. Man, did you hear the urgency in Billy's voice there?
Yeah, he understood that Austin was in trouble, and he motivated him to kick out. To Austin's credit, he was tough enough to get out.
And must be difficult for Billy as well, because he wants to win the match first and foremost, but he's also a father.
Of course.
He's also seen his children getting beaten up right now in the ring, getting kicked to the stomach, kicked in the face. It can't
and
be
mocked,
nice.
And he was just mocked. Ryzen just mocked. Taking one of Billy's things there, but no, I agree with everything you just said, Anthony. You're right. And as a dad, it's Definitely frustrating if you're Billy right now.
But Austin,
that was just an excellent suplex. He's got to try and get his brother in this thing or his dad.
Austin makes the tag. Colton Gunn, the legal man, as is Fiery Morales. Oh, Morales just gets taken down twice in a row. Colton, wow. He is fired up, man. Big splash in the corner. Another splash from Morales. Colton Gunn is on a roll here. Running power slam, hooks the far leg. Two, rising there to break it up in time.
Here comes Billy, oh, duck.
Billy takes Ryzen to the outside. Adam Priest isolated on the outside as well. Colton and Austin send Morales into the ropes. Looking for the 3-10 to Yuma. They hit it right there. One, two, three.
The winners of this match, the Gun Club.
Well, impressive victory right there for the father and son duo of the Gun Club. Impressive for sure. Good job by all three men.
Anthony, Gun Club remain undefeated as a trio here in AEW. That's a tough record to keep up.
That's a tough record, but they've got a lot of talent in that triumvirate right there. Great move.
That 3-10 to Yuma. The backdrop into almost like that quick draw that Austin uses. Great combination maneuver. The Gun Club victorious here tonight on AEW Dark. The number 5 ranked Santana and Ortiz will be in tag team action coming up next.
This is a tag team contest set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Making their way to the ring at a combined weight of 350 pounds, the team of John Cruz and Danny Limelight.
Taz, it was just about a week ago on AEW Dynamite. Danny Limelight teamed up with the Varsity Blondes to take on Kenny Omega and the so-called Elite. That was the Good Brothers, Carl Anderson and Doc Gallows. How impressive did Danny Limelight look in that matchup?
Oh, absolutely. And we've talked a lot about about Limelight out here. And many times on Doc, he's a tremendous competitor. So I was not shocked, but I was happy for him. But they got their hands full right now, buddy.
And their opponents from New York, New York, at a combined weight of 425 pounds, Santana and Ortiz.
Anthony, the number 5 ranked team here in AEW, Santana and Ortiz, tomorrow night on Dynamite, 8, 7 Central on TNT. They will be involved in a very important 3-way tag team matchup. It'll be Santana and Ortiz versus Chris Jericho and MJF versus Sammy Guevara and Jake Hager. The winners of that matchup will focus on winning the AEW World Tag Team Championship for the Inner Circle. Who do you like in that match tomorrow night?
Oh, that's a tough question. That's a tough question. I think you've got to lean towards the true tag team. And Santana and Ortiz, they know each other. They're like brothers. And I think you've got to lean towards them. You know, they know what each other are thinking all the time.
But Taz, you can't count out the experience, the complimentary organization of Chris Jericho. And, wow, jeez. Well, Santana looking pretty fired up. I was gonna say, Chris Jericho and MJF compliment each other so well.
Yeah, I know they do. I try not to get involved with other people's business, so I'm really not gonna comment much on it, to be frank.
Thanks for shutting me down, Taz.
No problem, but I'll tell you, Limelight was able to eat that nasty mat return by Santana, and he's back on offense. Let's see if Santana can stop him.
Santana, explosive first step, got around Limelight, hit him with that single leg drop kick across the jaw of Limelight. And we mentioned at the top of this match, Anthony, Limelight looked very impressive, hanging very, very well with the AEW World Champion, Kenny Omega, last week on Dynamite.
He equipped himself. Oh, better than he's doing right now, but against probably, arguably, the best wrestler in the world right now. He performed tremendously. This is going to be a great fight. This is going to be a great matchup. We've got four men.
John Cruz gets hung out to dry there by Santana and Ortiz.
We've got four men, four very proud Puerto Ricans with that Puerto Rican blood heritage running through their veins. I've boxed many Puerto Ricans back in the day. In my boxing days, they all hated to lose, and they were great fighters, every single one of them.
Big power bomb. Limelight rolled through. Santana, high stack. Whoa, man.
Wow.
State winners of this match.
Santana and Ortiz.
Well, that's the key, flying with momentum. Excuse me, going into Dynamite. Not looking to play games out here. No matter how good of an outing Danny Limelight had or not on Dynamite with Kenny Omega, the world champ, well, that's fine and well, but do what you got to do, and that's exactly what we saw Santana and Ortiz do.
I think the rest of the inner circle has been put on notice. Santana and Ortiz are not going to pull any punches tomorrow night on Dynamite.
Dynamite's highest flyer.
Great hang time!
The choice is yours. Cast your vote now at AEWAwards.com.
She got it.
Who is Dynamite's breakout female?
Oh, look at that!
The choice is yours. Cast your vote now at AEWAwards.com.
Taz, were you in band in high school?
I actually was. I've played many brass instruments, like a trumpet, a trombone, or a tuba. Also played many woodwind instruments, like you hear a saxophone now. I also played the clarinet and the xylophone.
You're a real Chuck Mangione type, Taz.
Yeah, similar. Feels so good, Excalibur.
It's time for me to grace you all with my presence, and baby, you're welcome.
Thanks, Pete.
What a great name.
For those of you who may not know who I am, my name is Pretty Peter Avalon. I'm the biggest man in pro wrestling. I'm the most handsome man on the AEW roster, and I am the premier featured attraction here on AEW Dark. And for those of you who do know who I am, you know that I've been on a bit of a winning streak lately these past couple weeks, beating the most handsome men in pro wrestling with Pretty Peter's pageant, Provocation. But it is time to take it to the next level. There are career-defining matches and moments, and it is time for PPA to have a career-defining match of his own. Pretty Peter's Pageant Provocation presents The Walk-Off.
Oh, wait till you hear about this.
Like a home run?
Lee Johnson.
Different.
You're a handsome young man. Last week, I was, I guess, checking you out.
What the hell?
And I gave you an 8x10, which you gladly accepted. Not only did you accept that 8x10, you accepted a picture of me, but you accepted my challenge for the walk-off. You might be asking yourself, Pete, what's the walk-off? Well, here are the rules.
Here we go, Excalibur. 3, 2, 1, read on.
You
sir.
See,
okay, maybe
with
not.
The walk-off, there's three beautiful judges. One outstanding outfit. There's going to be 10 steps forward. Pose, turn, and 10 steps back. And Lee, anybody can win a wrestling match, but it takes a real man like myself to win such a cosmetic contest. Lee Johnson, next week, I'm gonna prove to you and each and every one of these goofs that it's PPA all day.
Cannot wait for the walk-off, Excalibur. Can you believe we're gonna witness this?
Can barely contain myself, Taz.
Three pretty judges, one beautiful outfit.
10 steps and yeah.
Who deserves the most prestigious wrestling honor? It's the first ever AEW Dynamite Awards, hosted by Tony Schiavone. Vote now at AEWAwards.com.
This is a tag team bout set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring at a combined weight of 355 pounds, the team of Lee Johnson and Aaron Solo.
Taz, we've gotten a couple looks at this team of Johnson and Solo, and they've been impressive in the past. I think they're on the cusp of something.
Oh, I don't disagree. I'm a fan of both these young athletes for sure, man.
Oh my God, is that Private Party?
A walk-off next week for Johnson. PPA.
And their opponents being accompanied by Matt Hardy from a location where you need an invitation. At a combined weight of 24 ounces of vodka cranberry, Isaiah Cassidy, Mark Quinn, Private Party.
Taz, much like you, Matt Hardy has taken an interest in some of the younger wrestlers on our roster here in AEW, hoping to help guide their careers. But in doing so, may have taken an advantage of Private Party.
Well, what do you mean? What do you mean advantage? Matt Hardy giving his expertise.
He presented with the contract with a 30% fee for his managerial services.
No, he can't work for free. I mean, not everybody's like me with Team Taz. I'm such a giving man. I mean, I got a lot of problems. Money ain't one of them.
30% is usury, Taz.
It's definitely a high bid. It's definitely a high, percentage.
Private Party, I mean, Matt Hardy tried to frame it as the lesson is you always read the contract. You tried to make it into a teaching moment, but I don't know about it, Taz.
No, yeah, you should definitely read the fine print.
I mean, yes, I get that, but to offer somebody a contract like that in good faith.
Well, I blame Private Party for the miscue. I mean, Matt's just trying to make a buck, you know what I mean? He's got kids, bro.
Couldn't they use the money more than that?
Wild. Jeez. Paul Quinn. That was wicked.
Very impressive.
Hey, look, easy.
Matt, I got this. This one's for you.
Wow. He's calling off Matt Hardy. Matt Hardy's. Maybe should have listened to him.
Hardy. Ref did not. Ref's back was turned. Solo got tripped up by Matt Hardy.
Pay attention. What was what? What's that?
I didn't do anything.
Matt Hardy, I guess, really earning that 30% here tonight, Taz.
Well, he's trying to get a victory for his friends.
Show me some.
Side headlock there by Aaron Solo. Sent into the rope. Wow, comes back with a drop kick, takes down Mark Quinn. Solo grabs the front face lock.
Done a remove right there. Hook your opponent in a hold. Bring him to your corner. Don't leave him in the middle of the ring.
Double back elbow by Solo and Johnson. Hook of the far leg.
Oh, look how quick Quinn, smart to get Isaiah into this thing. I don't think Lee Johnson, he took his eye off the ball for a second. That's what happened.
Yeah, Private Party definitely the more experienced duo out of these two teams is Isaiah Cassidy inside the ring. Looking to take flight. Nope. Matt Hardy. Matt Hardy got in the way.
Yeah, well, that's why Isaiah stopped.
I think Hardy was trying to preach caution to Isaiah Cassidy.
Wow, Matt
Hardy. Oh, man.
Matt Hardy, a little tough love.
The drop kick from Big Shotty Lee Johnson as Private Party and Matt Hardy.
Show me some attitude. Show me some mentality. Come on, show me some mentality. Get here and win by any means necessary. Go.
Motivation. Yeah, Matt.
Yeah, he's trying to bring. He's trying to bring some intensity, some mean streak out of Private Party.
Yes. See, I don't have that problem with Team Taz. They're all very mean.
That's what I need out of you. That's what I need.
This is stuff by Matt Hardy, and by now seeing Isaiah getting motivated, but Lee Johnson catches him in a side headlock.
Nice grip there. by Lee Johnson.
Quinn got tagged in. I believe Mark Quinn got tagged in.
He did, and now the Manhattan drop. Lee Johnson tripped out the catapult into the corner. Lee Johnson hit the turnbuckle, I think. And now, well, poetry in motion, Taz.
It was well done.
And Quinn with the drop kick takes down Aaron Solo. Private Party looking good here. That little pep talk on the outside seemed to have paid dividends. Turn it up. Yes. Ooh, yes. Ripping yes. Chop to the That's chest by Mark you. Quinn.
That's what I want out of you.
Lee Johnson deposited on his back. Isaiah Cast.
No more showboating. No. Two. Go in there and pound his ass.
Matt, what are you talking about?
Matt Hardy saying, no going in for the kill.
What happened?
Cassidy went to drop the elbow, but he and Hardy spent too much time arguing on the outside, Taz.
Yes, well, that's the thing. I mean, I understand what Matt's doing, but he's also inadvertently distracting, you know, his guys.
Nice drop step there by Johnson into the Blue Thunder. Bomb, one, two, no.
Isaiah, get it together.
Taz, in that instance, I think it would almost have been better for Lee Johnson to hit the BT bomb and then roll backwards, kind of abandon ship, and make a quicker tag out to Aaron Solo.
Probably could have done that with a nice exploder right there by Aaron Solo.
Solo covers, hooks the far leg, just a two count, though.
The bigger picture is, you know, watching what's going on with Hardy.
Do not embarrass me, Isaiah.
Is he?
You are embarrassing me.
Man.
He is what? I want to hear what he's saying. He keeps just chirping him up a lot.
He's saying that Isaiah's embarrassing him.
Yeah. So I'm just, what I was fixing to say was that it's kind of like definitely distracting Private Party. I mean, Matt, I think his intentions are good intentions, but inadvertently, he's screwing him up a little bit.
Jawbreak. Oh, wow. As soon as Solo avoided the trip, the cover here, Bryce Rumsberg says it's only a two count. As soon as Solo avoided the trip, he got caught.
Very difficult in this industry to find proper representation. I humbly say I'm the best.
What's your percentage, Taz?
That's, I don't need to know this. I can't share that. That's private info. And I work mostly for free. I mean, that's just because, like I said, I don't need the money.
So magnanimous. Hanging neck breaker there. Great combination move by Solo and Johnson. Covers.
Most I want from Team Taz is friendship, love, camaraderie. I don't need it.
And for you to visit shopftw.com.
Buy a hat. Old Tasha.
Lee Johnson, Aaron Solo. Got Mark.
Ooh, went. Whoa. Knees.
Double knees. And double Rana.
Wow, we don't see that much.
Mark Quinn making the most out of those long legs of his. It's Isaiah Cassidy. He's feeling it here.
Sure is. Looking good. Back's big kick to the gut.
Aaron Solo. In some degree of trouble here. Stupid. Oh, the guillotine cutter sends Lee Johnson spilling to the floor. Solo.
Yeah, Solo rushed in a little too quick, got caught. Ooh, broke the grip, switch, standing switch.
And
no tag.
Rolled through.
Now there's a tag.
Tag the hip toss.
Legal man's coming in.
Quinn, big high crossbody. One, two, no. Lee Johnson there in time to break it up, keep his team alive.
Watch Isaiah.
Ooh, Isaiah Cassidy came down.
He did.
Clutching that left knee of his. And Matt Hardy barking orders. Aaron Solo comes over at the waist lock. O'Connor roll, one, two, nope. Oh, Hardy with a big right hand behind the referee's back.
What a shot.
Aaron Solo. A dazed look on his face.
Isaiah, though, he's limping around on that leg, though. On that knee is an issue. Didn't affect that double team kick.
Yeah, the stereo. NC Gary's cover here. One, two, three. Yeah. Yeah, after that right hand from Hardy, I'm not sure they even needed it.
No winners of this match. Private Party.
Yeah, they're going to check out that knee of Isaiah.
Well, Matt Hardy, instrumental in Private Party's victory here tonight on AEW Dark. Right here, this was how he was instrumental, Taz.
Yeah, just an overhand right, solo club that ref never saw it. Stereo, it's Jerry kicks, boom, and then gets the win, but he's got to keep an eye on that leg, that left knee, I believe it was, of Isaiah. Thanks up. I don't think Matt Hardy gives a rat's ass about Isaiah's knee.
I think he's worried about his investment going up in smoke, but
God, try it up.
What does the future hold for the Hardy Party?
Not much of a party, bro.
Not at all. Big Swole returns to action in the women's division coming up next here on AEW Dark.
This contest is set for a one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Making her way to the ring from San Antonio, Texas, Alex Gracia.
As Alex Gracia making her return to Dark tonight, a talented young competitor, but she is going to have her work cut out for her here tonight.
And her opponent from Clearwater, Florida,
Big Swole, you saw it there at the bottom of the screen, the number one contender here in the AEW women's division. There's some big things in her future. But Alex Gracia, Taz, you know she's going to have something to say about that.
Yeah, no, absolutely. But the thing is with Big Swole, you know, she's a special kind of athlete, special kind of tough, too. So, like you said at the top of this thing, before this, you know, as Swole came out, I believe, what you heard her music, basically that Gracia will have her hands full in this matchup.
And, you know, Swole fought hard to climb the rankings to grab that number one spot. She's not going to let go of it easily. Swole with control of the wrist of Gracia. Gracia rolls through, wrist lock of her own. Swole maneuvering Gracia around, takes into a side headlock.
I'll tell you what, I've heard on good accord that I'm very familiar, I should say that. I know that Swole has been training with the great Dean Malenko, you know, so when Swole gets an opportunity at the world title again, at Sheeta, she'll be more than prepared, you know, training with someone like Malenko, obviously.
Yeah, Swole has introduced that.
Texas Cloverleaf.
Yes, exactly, Taz, and to great results here. That is what helped her climb right up to that number one ranking.
For those that don't know what a Texas Cloverleaf is, it's a leg submission. And it's a nasty, nasty hold. And Malenko was one of the key guys who did that hold as a finishing move to great success.
Yeah, it's similar in technique to a Boston Crab, though the knees are
bent up a little bit.
Yeah, the knees are crisscrossed, and so it really puts a lot of pressure all over the opponent. Alex Gracia there.
Yeah, let's see if she can follow up. Swole's down. Here we go.
Gracia putting the pressure on Big Swole. See Swole frustrated there.
Yeah, she got caught, and now Gracia just hooks an arm bar. Maybe going to work on that right arm.
Maybe looking to neutralize that Texas Cloverleaf, Taz.
We'll see.
Yeah, Swole is a really tough out, but Gracia.
I mean, yeah, because if you injure, you know, the arms, she's got that arm locked up. She could turn it into a wrist lock. It's a wrist lock already, but turn it almost like a top wrist lock on the mat, like a key lock. But to your point, it definitely would affect Swole to apply the Texas Cloverleaf if you attack an arm.
Yeah, I mean, Swole, obviously very, very powerful arms and shoulders. Anything Gracia can do to neutralize that advantage that Swole possesses.
Yeah, no doubt. You're right, man. There's no doubt.
Whoa! Big kick in the corner. Swole in a bit of trouble here, Taz.
Yeah, watch, you gotta watch this. Ooh, that would have been a big upset.
That certainly would have.
He was able to kick out, though.
But Gracia bringing Big Swole up to her feet, but the rights and the lefts to the midsection of Gracia stopping her progress, and Swole. Oh, man, big back elbow. Gracia thinking maybe hanging neck breaker. Swole escapes out of it, pump kick.
A big Swole trying to get amped up here.
Swole definitely feeling it. Oh, the cross chops. A second one.
Yeah, good power, good speed use. Those forearm shots.
Missed roundhouse.
Yeah, missed a low kick.
But the headbutt didn't miss. Gracia on roller skates there. Swole.
Ripcord with Dirty Dancing.
Boom! Right on the money.
The winner of this match, Big Swole.
Well, we talked a lot about the Texas Clover Leaf and now Swole training with the great Dean Malenko, but hey, she could beat you several different ways and ends up with that ripcord into that driving forearm.
That's what makes Big Swole so dangerous, Taz.
Yes, yes, yes. That's how she got herself the win. But she, yeah, right here, you see the Dirty Dancer. And here it comes, boom.
Pow, right on the money. Big Swole ends the night of Alex Gracia and continues her ascent here in the women's division of All Elite Wrestling. The Concrete Rose, Sonny Kiss, goes one-on-one with Zach Clayton next here on AEW Dark.
This contest is set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Making his way to the ring from Albany, New York, weighing 265 pounds, Zach Clayton.
Zach Clayton making his return here tonight to AEW Dark. Very talented competitor with a lot of promise, Taz.
Yeah, he's got good size on him. Definitely, athletic for sure. So let's see how he can rock and roll here against the unorthodox opponent he has.
And his opponent, from Jersey City, New Jersey, weighing 188 pounds, the Concrete Rose, Sonny Kiss.
Has Sonny stole your jacket?
I don't have a jacket like that.
You don't have a jacket that says Babe on the back?
No, I don't. I was never even thinking of getting one, but maybe I should get one with, if they have it like with orange and black letters, maybe I'll get it to say Babe. Well, no, that's taken. I can't do that. Can't use that. My bad. Sorry. It's my friend. I know it's...
My best friend!
Bye-bye. That'll pop to you.
Off the rails.
Whoa, nice! Into that drop toe hold. Well done by Sonny. That was really nice.
Yeah, Sonny, transitioning into...
That was cool.
Front chancery. Clayton using his size, though. Pushing Sonny off of the... Oh, man! That shin of Sonny Kiss caught...
Yeah, crazy flexibility by Sonny. And look at the athleticism. We've seen it time and time again here on AEW programming.
The back of Sonny's leg smashing Clayton in the face, and then just the hop up hook on Rana. Oh man!
That was some shot.
Taz, we're seeing Sonny showing some uncharacteristic aggression, but got shut down by Zach Clayton right there.
Yeah, Clayton realized that he was getting put behind the blocks real quick by Kiss and shut down Sonny with that. That shot was nasty.
Clayton with Sonny Kiss, center of the ring. Delayed vertical suplex. Really giving Sonny time to think about it.
Big power right there by Clayton.
Clayton hits the ropes, drops the knee across the face of Sonny. Sonny kicks out. Sonny Kiss being brought back up to a vertical. Oh, man. Sonny strikes, Taz, have really elevated.
Yeah, a lot of pop, a lot of mustard, as we used to call it back in the day, mustard behind those shots.
And you saw the eyes of Zach Clayton thinking, WTF here, man.
Well, yeah, with Sonny's style and the way Sonny dresses and competes, you wouldn't think that someone likes the style of Sonny would be as physical, but hence the moniker Concrete Rose. I mean, tough as hell is Sonny Kiss.
Yeah, Sonny is tough as he is pretty. Switches there into the ropes. Clayton. Oh, Sonny Vaults over that top. Another roundhouse kick, dropping Clayton this time. And Sonny Kiss with an opportunity here, Taz. Over that top into the splitting leg drop. Double duck, but no avoiding that shot from Sonny Kiss.
Yeah, strong right across the jaw, right across the button area.
Kick to the midsection, kick to the chest. And just a leaping flatliner there from Sonny Kiss. Sonny taking a moment to think about it.
Well, Sonny realizes that Clayton's down and out.
Oh, wow.
That might be it.
Diving leg drop gets the three and the victory.
Here is your winner, the Concrete Rose, Sonny Kiss.
Taz, this is the most aggressive we have seen Sonny Kiss in his AEW career.
Yeah, I mean, listen, Sonny has that proverbial chip on the shoulder, and I think that's why you're seeing much more. I gotta say, I feel Sonny's always been very physical in the ring.
But I'm
just amped up, though.
Yeah, out of the gate, Sonny came out hot.
I agree. Sorry.
No, it's all right. Sonny picks up the victory, and Taz, send a text to your tailor. I want to see you in that jacket next time we're here.
Babe. Bang.
What's Dynamite's biggest WTF moment?
Oh, my God!
The choice is yours. Oh! Cast your vote now at AEWAwards.com.
Darius and Dante Martin, top flight. Look to keep up their winning streak in the new year. They will be in tag team action next year on AEW Dark.
This is a tag team bout set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Making their way to the ring at a combined weight of 345 pounds, the team of KC Navarro and AJ Kirsch.
345 pounds combined weight.
Yeah, it's like an easy day for Brian Cage in the gym.
That's Hobbs too. Hobbs basically dead rat, little fat. Hook benches it. Stocks just does whatever he wants with that kind of weight.
We can get him back out here for this match, won't it? I'll text him.
And their opponents from Minneapolis, Minnesota, at a combined weight of 405 pounds, Darius and Dante Martin, top flight.
That's top flight, undefeated here in the new year. A great start for the coldest team in the game.
Love top flight. Could you imagine top flight being part of some type of a group or faction here in AEW? Could you imagine that?
Yeah, I think it'd be a great addition to the inner circle.
I don't know. They have an excellent team there already, the inner circle called Santana Ortiz.
Well, they could have MJF and Chris Jericho teaming up, or they...
Well, I meant that's a firm team, you know.
Well, I know, but that's tomorrow night on Dynamite. We're gonna find out which unit from the inner circle is gonna challenge for the AEW World Tag Team titles.
Well, you're welcome. I set it up on a tee for you, but I also was trying to make some points out here. That's okay. It's okay.
Getting our first look here tonight at AJ Kirsch. As Darius Martin starts out for top flight. Side headlock there by AJ Kirsch.
Yeah, buddy. Yes.
Really, just beware of top flight. You know, I don't know if Mr. Kirsch realizes this. These two young men are insane athletes, just special.
Darius rolls Kirsch back through, but Kirsch trucked him with that shoulder tackle.
Kind of had the hand down at the side, Kirsch. You're not going to get as much impact when you do that.
Nope.
But it worked.
Yeah. Darius Martin, though.
Well, nice roll. Yeah, you can see that roll was coming. It was well done by Darius.
And immediately seizes the wrist of Kirsch, brings him over to the corner, tags in the younger brother, Dante.
Oh, nice flipper, right? Look at that flipper, and then, boom.
Ooh, and a drop kick to the shoulder, Taz.
Yeah, that's a good strategy. Here comes Navarro.
Yeah, KC Navarro. Ooh, just gets ripped by those double chops.
Pick the ankle, pick the calf. Oh, nice roll through, grab the wrist, and look at this. Guys are so good, man.
So good, so fast, Taz. We say it a lot, like how do you find people to train with that match up to the skills and abilities? you know, top flight or emblematic of that. Who compares to them?
It's no one. I mean, unless you're going to go start training, you know, with teams like the Young Bucks or something like that, you're really not going to find like a Private Party, you know, teams like that that have that type of crazy high-flying athletic style. Navarro, though, for not as big as an athlete, we've seen him enough. He's very intense and a lot of good physicality by Navarro. I like this young athlete. Oh,
whoa.
Put the brakes on and that drop kick. That was cool.
Suckered in Dante Martin. Dante threw the drop kick. Nobody home. He had full extension on that, but this time.
Oh, God.
Wow, man. Just doing almost a backflip off the chest of Casey Navarro. But Navarro, wow, man, using that lower fulcrum and dropping Dante on the back of his head.
Well, even though he's not as heavy, Navarro was able to just get his leverage, you know, lower his level, get his hips under him and get that throw off.
AJ Kirsch doing a little bit of talking, but Dante Martin letting his boots talk for him. Though he got dumped off the corner by Navarro onto the knee of AJ Kirsch. Kirsch now covers here. Oh, not to cover.
Yeah, not smart not to get that cover there. You had an opportunity to keep, you know, to get a cover on a man while his brother's all the way across the ring, far away. I don't know why Kirsch did not get a cover there, but you know, maybe he wanted to get more offense going, and he's beating the heck out of him right now, so it's working.
And continuing to talk the ear of Dante Martin, Dante Martin off, but the Northern Lights suplex. And the two count there for AJ Kirsch. Dante trying to fight free of the grip. Navarro with the blind tag in. Seeing some good tag team cohesion here from Navarro and Kirsch, Taz.
Yeah, definitely intense, physical. Navarro, they're just talking a lot of trash. I mean, both Navarro and Kirsch talk a lot of trash towards Top Flight. They don't like him. It's pretty obvious.
Oh, cover here. One, two, no. Navarro grabbing the leg of Dante. Dante lands on his feet. Blind tag out there by Darius. Great heads up teamwork. Pile driver attempt. And Navarro! Wow!
Man, what a cross body.
And older brother Darius peppering the opposition with shots. Double boots. Flips through. Swing and a miss there by Navarro. And standing Spanish fly hooks the far leg. One, two. Kirsch there in the nick of time to break it up.
Amazing. Spanish fly was insane.
Kirsch sent to the outside. And Dante,
a moonsault here, yeah.
Off the middle turnbuckle, neutralizes Kirsch on the outside. Casey Navarro on the inside was thinking swinging DDT. Darius rolls him through, has the high stack. One, two, three, wow.
The winners of this match, Top Flight.
Taz, man, that was a lightning strike roll-up victory there.
That was awesome, dude. Yes, listen, these two young guys, they can beat you so many different ways. Big fan of Top Flight.
We have only scratched the surface of what
that moonsault will be.
Top Flight possesses. Every time we see them, Taz, a new dimension of their game is shown to us. They are going to be the team to watch in 2021. Winners of the AEW Women's Tag Team Cup Tournament, Eva Lise and Diamante will be in tag team action next here on AEW Dark.
This is a tag team contest set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Making their way to the ring, the team of Tesha Price and Catalina Perez.
Taz, when you call your tailor to get that that Sunny Kiss style jacket, you might want to get a Catalina Perez style jacket while you're at it.
Yeah, I looked into that. There is orange, actually. An orange furry buffer, they call it.
Well,
so that's what I'm going to get.
I think it would actually, you would have to hunt down and kill Gritty, the Philadelphia Flyers mascot, and skin him in order to make an orange jacket like that.
It's probably illegal to do all of that, but okay. No problem.
And their opponents
the team of La Sicaria, Ivelisse, and Diamante.
Taz, we were making jokes just a couple seconds ago, having a little bit of a laugh.
Well, I call it fun conversation.
We were having a light and fun conversation, but two women that I never see engaged in a light or fun conversation are Ivelisse and Diamante. Always...
business.
Yes.
I just have to be. And, you know, I have fun out here with you, my friend Excalibur, Bowling Dog.
Hey, thanks for calling me your friend.
You got it. But when it's Team Taz business, I don't play games. Like Diamante. You know, and she's the same exact way, as is Ivelisse, as is his team. So let's see if Price can deal with Diamante right now in this tag team matchup.
Tasha Price not backing down from Diamante. Looking for the hip toss there. Knee to the midsection. Tasha Price lands on her.
Lost that.
Diamante just put the boot on the face of Price. Price takes her down, though.
She kept trying to kip up, couldn't get it, but that's all right. She got the arm drag.
Another arm drag takes down Diamante. And tag out to Catalina Perez. Perez and Price.
Go for a double vertical maybe here, or maybe a double snap.
A lot of footwork there, but they still got it off. Hook at the far leg.
Yeah, definitely make a good point. A lot of footwork, a lot of unnecessary footwork, to be honest. They could have just turned a little quarter step and got that thrown off instead of going to the middle, but then go for cover.
You know, when you're teaming up for the first time, that cohesion, right, not always there. Cover here.
Correct.
And, you know, that familiarity that comes with a regular team, you know where your partner, you know, if they like to favor going to their left or, right, to their right. These two women, Perez and Price, still finding that out.
Footwork is such an underrated thing for pro wrestling. I don't think a lot of fans don't realize it. You know, and they shouldn't. I mean, it's a big part of success.
First DDT there by Ivelisse.
Getting wins and being offensive in matches and dominant. Footwork is key.
Well, I mean,
teamwork or singles, it don't matter.
It's all about the efficiency of movement, conserving energy. You know, that's what, you know, like. That's what's so important about being able to, sure, place your feet in the right place.
She's right there, right in the middle, she gets herself. Wow, Ivelisse, nice vertical suplex in to that front guillotine.
Catalina Perez in trouble here.
She took full body scissors if she wanted, Ivelisse, but I kind of like what she's doing. She's got her weight on her one knee.
And look at that, positioning her back. As soon as Perez started to try to get to a vertical
position. Over. Yeah, she swept her over.
Ooh.
Nice.
Tough, that was a dirty kick from the back by Ivelisse.
You know, it is with Ivelisse, she's got a motor, right? You know, she just doesn't stop. Her cardio's amazing. And she's a veteran. She knows what she's doing. She's got a lot of match experience, high-level match experience.
Leaping elbow strike there by Diamante.
Yeah, I think Miss Perez here is beat up pretty roughly.
Yeah, we've mentioned how Ivelisse and Diamante were the first ever winners of the AEW Women's Tag Team Cup Tournament. They have proven their mettle time and time again. But Catalina Perez.
Well, they earned it in that tournament. They were, you know, a lot of people thought in the finals they were gonna lose that tournament.
But yeah, they got
Ali and Brandy.
Oh! Shot to the midsection there.
Right, everybody, that's what most folks thought they were gonna lose.
Yeah, you're exactly right, Taz, but Ivelisse and Diamante were able to persevere. They overcame the odds. They won that tournament. And since then, I mean, they have been a formidable duo here.
Tasha Price coming in, as is Ivelisse.
Back elbow takes Ivelisse off her feet. Back elbow takes down Diamante. Tasha Price. The cartwheel into the roundhouse kick. And the Bulldog hooks the far leg, does Tasha Price, only gets a two count.
Yeah, a lot of intensity and exuberance out of Tasha Price there, but not enough to beat Ivelisse yet. Anyway, we'll see.
Ivelisse backing Price to the corner. Oh, shotgun drop kick there. Ivelisse may have miscalculated there, and Tasha Price taking advantage.
Yeah, I think you're right. That's exactly what went down.
Now, suplex attempted, Ivelisse. Oh!
Wow, she got rocked.
Stunned her with the enziguri, the swinging neck breaker there by Catalina Perez. One, two, no. As I think that would have been something of an upset had Diamante not come into the ring.
Big time. Yeah, definitely would have been. Now you see Diamante wearing out Tesha Price, and Catalina Perez just caught that kick.
One, two, three. Wow.
The winner of this match,
the team of Diamante and La Sicaria, Ivelisse.
Well, as we talked about how important footwork is, the foot of Ivelisse went to work on the head of Catalina Perez, and that was the end of the night.
Yeah, it doesn't take much when you bring that kind of intensity we saw right there in that kick. Get the victory. The great job by Ivelisse and Diamante.
Powerful shot there by Ivelisse. She and Diamante victorious here tonight on AEW Dark.
Who deserves the most prestigious wrestling honor? It's the first ever AEW Dynamite Awards, hosted by Tony Schiavone. Vote now at AEWAwards.com.
Fuego del Sol teams up with the captain, Sean Dean, to take on Max Caster, Anthony Bowens, the Acclaimed, next here on AEW Dark.
This is a tag team contest set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring at a combined weight of 360 pounds, the team of Sean Dean and Fuego del Sol.
The captain and Fuego teaming up again here tonight on AEW Dark.
What's a good name for this team is Captain Fuego. All right, take that out of the edit that out. Captain Fuego! And they come out with like a bunch of flame pyro blowing off.
And their opponents at a combined weight of 556 pounds, Anthony Bowens, Max Caster, the Acclaimed.
Well, they're going to come out with pyro, but there's none left after Cody's entrance.
Yeah. We gonna pour the water on Fuego. He only wear masks cause he couldn't draw a peso. Standing on my payload, you still 3 feet. My last rap got me heat, but they can't see me. Sean Dean coming back, but it's just a repeat. You could call me daddy, you're about to be beat. Yo, your only talent is getting no dough. You would get voted off of the Go Big Show real quick. Real quick. Please back him up. Please back him up.
You know what, Taz? Say what you will.
AEW!
Wow, okay.
The best part.
The Acclaimed have arrived!
Say what you will about Max Caster and his raps, but he understands corporate synergy.
Oh, he does. He's very intelligent. I know Max Caster very well. Yeah, and for a while, I know him. He's far from dumb, and as is Bowens. Corporate synergy, yes.
Hope everybody enjoyed the premiere of Go Big Show on TBS.
I know I did.
A few days ago.
Except for Cody.
What was your favorite part?
Not Cody. No disrespect to Cody.
Well, I mean, think about this, Taz. If Cody didn't use all that pyro, imagine the entrance Sean Dean and Fuego could have.
It'd be even more flames.
Oh, it'd be great. Captain Fuego.
Captain Fuego, this one half of the team right there. The Tornado DDT, if it comes out, Caster and Bowens is in trouble. That's Fuego's big move.
He has yet to hit the Tornado DDT in the AEW ring. But once he does, I understand, it is certain.
Legendary.
Doom.
It's legendary throughout Mobile and Dothan, Alabama.
Dothan nearly killed him.
Dothan. Did you ever wrestle him?
Yeah, I did.
Did you?
Yeah,
I did. You over there? You're walking for the house. Just leave it at that. Okay?
Big boot into the jaw, Sean Dean. Side headlock there by Max Caster.
Yeah. The captain's got to try up some spots just to get him off, get some separation. And, look at Caster. Golly.
Caster hits the rope. Sean Dean leapfrogs up and over the top. Cross body. Wow, Caster, man.
Ooh, got buckled up there.
Both hands underneath Dean's ribs. The captain heads to the outside, rolls through. A little bit of a misdirect there. Wow, was that a misdirect?
That was definitely a misdirect. Did you say misdirect? There's a lot of misdirects.
Misdirect nearly killed him.
That'd be a good name for a guy, Mr. Wreck. Mr. Wreck!
That's Hook's nickname. Watch it. Oh, diving crossbody there by the captain.
That was nice by the captain for sure. Let's see if he can follow up now.
Ooh! Big clothesline there. Sean Dean goes for the cover.
Bowen's about to get in and break it up, but he didn't have to. He's paying attention. That's smart. It's key.
Dean was reaching towards the corner, trying to make the tag out to Fuego, but Max Caster in complete control of this match. Blind tag there for Bowens. Bowens. Oh, man, the neck breaker.
Nasty.
Cover here, one, two, no.
Hey, tip your lid right there to the captain on that kick out.
Man, powerful elbow there. Across the jaw.
Might have been a forearm. Sorry. Got a cold. I can see that, Excalibur. Forearms. Bro, you can get hot. I don't care. I'm just telling you, it was a forearm, bro. I'm going to tell you. You give me a dirty look over here. You give me Snake Guy Jones.
I don't come down to the Team Taz Dojo and tell you how to do your job.
You are not allowed to come into the Team Taz Dojo. How about that? Oh, look at that misdirect.
Meeting of the minds there for the acclaimed.
Watch Fuego.
Fuego takes the skies. Double drop kick takes down Caster and Bowens.
Do it for Mobile. Mobile's favorite luchador.
That Tierra sends Caster into Bowens.
He's from Mobile, right?
Yes. Is this your first day?
No, I have a lot of cities in Alabama. Just want to make sure.
Oof, a lot of cities everywhere, Taz. Assisted slice spread there. One, two, no.
Fuego, you just said it. Fuego. And he just throws his hand around. Oh, what was that little, see that little Jimmy step he did?
He's going for the tornado DDT.
Oh, he stopped the Caster stop.
Oh!
Out of one of the greatest counters I've ever seen. Oh, might have been overstated. Tony Schiavone, line one.
You, Taz, hyperbole?
Hey, I don't care. Hyperbole. I never hyperbole. I wash.
They've got Fuego set up. Caster off the top. Critically acclaimed. Bowens covers. Two, three.
The winners of this match,
the acclaimed.
The acclaimed, top of the chain, so I bet you know the name.
The acclaimed continue their meteoric rise here in All Elite Wrestling. The deepest tag team division anywhere in the acclaimed, making a name for themselves.
I mean, yeah, they are completely dominant. I mean, no matter what, they talk a bunch of smack and they finish the job, man. They just get win after win, no matter who the teams are they're facing. Got to, you know, keep an eye on the acclaimed, man. They are no joke.
Anthony Bowens, Max Caster, the acclaimed, victorious here tonight on AEW Dark.
Who is Dynamite's breakout female? The choice is yours. Cast your vote now at AEWAwards.com.
Luther and Serpentico Chaos Project will take on Rey Fénix and Penta El Cerro Miedo in our AEW Dark main event coming up next.
This is a tag team contest set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first at a combined weight of 430 pounds, Luther Serpentico Chaos Project.
Taz, big tag team main event matchup here on AEW Dark. Thanks for that. Dynamite drop in.
Well, the Chaos Project's in the house. You never know what the hell's gonna happen next, Cal, but some strange individuals. Tell you what, there's gonna be a day, I don't know when, but this Serpentico.
He's gonna get
his buddy.
He get tuned up like Powerhouse.
That's it.
Did last week here on Dark.
Delta Valley, that's what happens. Play around for a while, crazy mask man. We'll get your ass. You know what the problem is.
Luther. Stuck to his tongue.
Just up chuck some streamers. Utah Pros,
Mexican. And their opponents being accompanied to the ring by Pac from Mexico City, Mexico. At a combined weight of 383 pounds, Penta El Cerro Miedo.
Cass, great to see Death Triangle here on AEW Dark. What about that victory Pac picked up over Eddie Kingston last week on AEW Dynamite?
Crazy physicality, two guys that don't play games, different styles, but both just trying to outmatch each other with intensity and physicality for sure, as far as Kingston and Pac. Big fan of Pac, big fan of the Lucha Bros.
And we would be remiss if we did not mention that AEW World Championship title match between Kenny Omega and Rey Fénix. One of the all-time classic Dynamite matches, one of the best matches of the last 12 months for sure.
Oh, it was outstanding.
As Penta El Cerro Miedo starting things off against Luther here tonight in our main event.
Very interesting, you know, two teams here, like really opposites. I mean, as far as clash of styles, you know, we said it a lot as announcers. Well, this dude, yeah. It's really just unique style.
Taz, I think the odd man out in this match is the odd man, always the odd man out. It's Luther, who, you know, Serpentico, obviously, a student of Lucha Libre?
Yes, no, he is. But you know, as you know, Cass Project, they have that offense where, which I'm assuming we're going to see, where Luther uses Serpentico as a weapon. That has a not usually with a luchador style, but I get your point.
No, it's not. But Penta tried to take advantage early. Luther got that high boot and now sends Penta into the corner, very nearly sandwiching Aubrey Edwards there.
Aubrey just ended up finding herself rarely in the wrong spot, and that could happen because you never use unorthodox as Luther.
Irish whip reversed there. Blind tag out to Serpentico. Comes diving in with the crossbody. Penta shot him off, though, made the tag out to Rey Fénix, and Rey Fénix leapfrogs up and over Serpentico.
Be careful, Serpentico. I don't know if you want to match anything against Fénix. This guy is one of the best athletes you're going to find in a pro wrestling ring. And he's tough as hell, too.
Double palm thrust to the chest. Cazadora here by Serpentico. Went for the arm drag. Fénix stopped him in his track. Steps around.
Serpentico's giving up some size to Fénix. So hence why he blocked the arm drag, did Fénix.
Cazadora
again. Yeah.
Again, but Serpentico launches off the top rope.
That was nice.
Transitions into a sunset flip. Fénix and Serpentico both going for side headlocks. Neither man able to make it. The hand, the show of respect being offered here by Rey Fénix. Oh, and the thrust kick.
Blast him.
And Taz,
he just tore him up with that shot, bro.
How about last week on Dynamite? It was the Elite. We thought it was going to be Kenny Omega and the Young Bucks. It turned out to be Kenny Omega and the Good Brothers.
Yes.
After the match, John Moxley confronted him, and then who should come to Moxley's aid but none other than Rey Fénix and Penta El Cerro Miedo.
Yeah, very interesting stuff. Oh!
Short DDT there by Serpentico as he covers. Two. I'm not sure anybody would have, if you took bets around the locker room, who's gonna come out to save John Moxley? Nobody would have had money on the Lucha Bros.
Well, I agree, but it was interesting to see. I mean, who knows if Team Taz wasn't as busy as we were, you know, getting ready to prepare Brian Cage for Darby Allin, you know, maybe we would have helped Mox. Probably not, though, because of our past.
Well, Taz, no secret that there's a lack of good feeling. Cover here by Luther. A lack of good feelings between yourself and that rat Fink Don Callis.
No comment.
Okay. And so I almost expect Team Taz to put their nose in Callis' business, but.
Best thing he could do is avoid anything involving me and my crew. Now, Serpentico legal. Let's see what happens here.
Scoop and a slam there. And Serpentico, Serpentico saying no.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, he actually flipped out of it.
Ah, that's a rare one. That's a rare one.
Luther, oh, the bulldog onto Penta.
He pulled it off anyway.
And not just headbutting.
I mean, it's unorthodox, but it's actually legal.
It's legal, but I mean, it's really diminishing
your partner.
It's diminishing your partner, diminishing your chances to win.
I mean, I think at this point, Serpentico might have like an epiphany to say, maybe I need to get away from this psycho bastard that's my partner.
Do you think, how do you think Serpentico and Luther communicate?
They text, I would think. Maybe DM on IG. I'm just trying to be cool with the kids in terms, you know, letters.
He's in WhatsApp?
Yeah.
Overhand shot, kick to the midsection. Luther sent into the breadbasket, perhaps a little lower on Serpentico. Sling blade here by Penta.
Penta's got to try to get his brother into this thing here.
Penta needs to make that crawl. Can he do it? He does. Tags out to Ray Phoenix. Phoenix comes in, drop kick, takes Luther off his feet.
That was tremendous. Makes it look easy.
And Serpentico got right up, walked into that thrust kick. And now Ray Phoenix maybe going to give Luther a little bit of his own medicine there. Cover hooks the far leg. Serpentico able to kick out. Ray Phoenix charged. Ooh. Oh, man. Charged into that boot, but Penta got the boot up into the face of Gamangiri.
Big mistake by Serpentico doing any kind of offensive stuff out of that corner of his opponent. I don't know what he was thinking there.
The power bomb and the perineal punisher. One, two, no.
Pac has been awfully quiet on the outside in the corner of the Lucha Bros, but no need right now for him to do anything. But main man in Death Triangle for sure. Now Phoenix, what's he got? Oh, you know what's up. Here we go.
The package pile driver, foot stomp combination. No, Luther pulls out the leg of Ray Phoenix. Serpentico avoids contact from Penta. Flips through, goes,
damn, almost kicked his mask off.
Ray Phoenix walking the tightrope on top, takes down Luther.
Just amazing.
Double underhook. Pile driver combination from the Lucha Bros. Cover, one, two, three.
The winners of this match,
the Lucha Brothers.
Man, oh man, what a match. What kind of insane offense Lucha Bros can bring. Now you see the embrace with Pac.
Great to
Triangle,
see,
bro.
Yeah, great to see Death Triangle back in action here in AEW. And Taz, a return to form for Lucha Bros. They haven't been teaming together all that much recently.
A little banged up here and there, you know, that's why.
Yeah, but they have, they showed that they are one of the toughest teams in the deepest tag team division in the world. Thank you for joining us here tonight on AEW Dark. Tomorrow night, 8-7 Central on TNT.
The Inner Circle will face off in a three-way tag team match to determine which duo will represent the group in the AEW tag team division. It's Negative One's birthday next week, and Hangman Adam Page will team up with the Dark Order to celebrate as they take on TH2 and Chaos Project in a big eight-man tag team matchup. Matt Hardy and his clients Private Party will be in six-man action next week as they take on the trio of Matt Sydal and Dante and Darius Martin, Top Flight. And the former AEW World Champion Jon Moxley will be in action next week.
For myself, Excalibur, for the Human Suplex Machine, Taz, for Justin Roberts, the Dapper Yapper, good night, everyone!